Hello, I'm Garima Tripathi from RKGIT Ghaziabad. We shall be discussing the part 2 or lecture 34 under the subject code BP504T, Pharmacognosy and Phytochemistry 2. The topic that we are discussing today is extraction of crude drugs and the specialized sophisticated supercritical fluid extraction and various types of extraction. So, supercritical fluid extraction, this is comparatively very recent method of extraction of crude drugs. In this particular extraction, the liquid extraction, the liquid solvent which is used to for extraction is being replaced by supercritical fluid. So, what is the term? How do we define supercritical fluid as such? So, this in general, when we define substance boiling point, it is referred to as the maximum amount of vapor pressure which is generated and is equivalent to the external pressure at that particular given temperature. So, in case of supercritical fluid, gases behave like fluids, and this particular property is achieved once the pressure is increased, the boiling point of these particular gases also increase and they behave like fluids. So, now moving to further, so these there are various gases under this example. What we will be discussing as such in the our complete lecture would be carbon dioxide. In phytochemistry, we or in pharmacy, we generally use this carbon dioxide for the separation of the phytoconstituents. Other important gases under this category could be ethylene, ammonia, as well as certain methanols, ethanol and other gases are also used for this purpose. Okay. So, these gases behave like free flowing liquids and are termed as supercritical fluids under certain under a typical or a particular critical point of temperature and pressure. So, this typical temperature is defined as T, P and P C at the critical temperature. So, these supercritical fluids have high penetration power and have high efficiency for extraction. So, initially this SPE or sometimes it is also referred as SCF extraction was done for food packaging industry to remove or deodorize the packed food material. The smell which food during the packaging was imparted is also due to of certain phytoconstituents having a characteristic smell, and using this those gaseous substances or those volatile substances or smelly substances was removed, and later it was incorporated in the phytochemistry for extraction. So, carbon dioxide at a critical temperature of 73.83 bar pressure as well as the temperature 31.06 degree centigrade behaves as a supercritical fluid. So, at this critical point, it gets liquefied or it is a free flowing liquid and can be used or can be used or assist for the extraction of phytoconstituents. So, this particular yaha pe we must describe that the three main important differences or parameters which enhances the extraction ability of the supercritical fluids are: number one, increase in the solvation strength, increase in the solvation strength. Now, these gases which is liquefied have a very high penetration power, and then so are capable of solvating the analytes or the solutes. Then second important parameter is the high diffusion. So, they behave here the gaseous property of these solvent or these supercritical fluids increases the diffusion property of the supercritical fluid, and hence the penetration is easier. And then the most important factor which enhances the process of extraction is absence or no presence of surface tension or surface meniscus, no surface tension. So, in the absence of surface tension between the cell-cell contents, the solvation or solubilization is high, and there is high reduction of the or you can say the viscosity is reduced, and that affects the extraction immensely. So, with the help of this phase diagram of CO2, we shall discuss some important arenas of the supercritical fluid. We can see here, this is the triple point at this particular temperature, as said 31.06 or 0.1, and this particular temperature, this the carbon dioxide gas behaves like supercritical fluid, and this is the critical, this is the triple point where the all the three phases are present, and this is the critical point after which the there is no demarcation between the gaseous phase and the liquid phase of the molecule or the gas we are choosing. So, here the gaseous and liquid phase are completely mixed up, there is no demarcation between them, giving the property of the gas to help to penetrate, and giving the property of the fluid to solvate or solubilize, and then the reduction in the surface tension is the added advantage. Okay, next is the advantages of supercritical fluid. Number one, it is sterile and bacteriostatic. Secondly, it is non-combustible and non-explosive. Again, as carbon dioxide is also an harmless, that is non-toxic gas or to the environment, and does not produce any waste product during the process of extraction. It is also available in large amount under the favorable condition. Okay, the mixture to be fractionated is passed into the extraction column along the length way of which the heater is located. Now, this heater is gives the desired amount of temperature so that the pressurized gas would turn into fluid, and at the critical temperature and pressure they can behave both as fluid and the gaseous material, that is supercritical fluid. Okay, so once the carbon dioxide is purged through the extraction column which is pressurized, and the drug material gets saturated. This saturation is because of the diffusion or penetration of the fluid, and which moves along the column of along the length of the column. The operating condition, that is the either the pressure and the temperature are selected, and if the operation of pressure controlled type of extraction is selected, the separation stage to precipitate the extract is there, and again the gas is recompressed for the recycle. Okay. Next, if the temperature control operation during the extraction is selected, the extract has to be precipitated by the heating solution which lowers the solvent density. Once the density is then increased by isobaric, that is same isobaric cooling for the recycling operation. Next, a PC is used to control the whole system. It also, apart from pressure and temperature, it also controls the flow rate of the gas. Then it is programmed safely to shut down in case of any over pressure or over temperature situation. So, here is the diagram or layout of the super critical fluid extractor, we shall see. So this is the temperature controlled oven. Under this, this is the oil bed or the extractor. The fluid is the from here the carbon dioxide, the is a supercritical fluid runs through this column, and then it is circulated. If it is a pressure controlled or temperature controlled, it will choose accordingly, and then finally it is collected. Here when the heated or temperature control system or operating system is used, then the collection takes place here. The recycling of the carbon dioxide gas takes place under this section. Next is the application of SPE or SCF. So it is typically used for decaffeination of coffee, extraction of pyrethrins, and for the production of terpene-less oils. Now, what is decaffeination? The coffee contains some high amount of proportion of caffeine, and the processing of coffee requires, or a better option is to remove the caffeine, making it more healthier in terms of its antioxidant property. Okay. Then comes the extraction of pyrethrins and the production of terpene-less oils. Okay. Next is selective extraction of larger proportion of active ingredients than the conventional method of hydrodistillation or extraction. See here, as already mentioned, in the conventional method of extraction, we use the solvents, and the complete extraction depends on the solvation property, the way the solvent can dissolve the solute into it, the penetration property, the way the solvent or the time or the ability of the solvent to penetrate into the cell material, and after solvation taking away the solute as a free cell solution into the towards achieving the equilibrium with the solvent system. And obviously there are other interaction like surface tension, viscosity, and other parameters. So once this method of supercritical fluid is achieved, there is higher, far more better achievement of the proportion of the active constituent, especially in case of Acoron from Acorus calamus. This is again an anti-inflammatory drug, and then we have this example matricine and bisabolol from chamomile flowers. Again, there are various heat labile sesquiterpenes which get deteriorated at a certain temperature. So increasing the pressure allows these sesquiterpenes to get extracted at a better temperature, okay. So from the Nardostachys species, that is Jatamansi and the Valerian. Okay. Now removal of the odors, as already mentioned, from these freshly distilled essential oils. Some more important examples of this supercritical fluid extraction would be Taxol, which is an anti-cancer drug, Taxol, and it is again a diterpene. Okay. Here also carbon dioxide gas is used for extraction. Next is primrose, which is a fixed oil. Here either ethylene or ethanol is used for the extraction. Then we have rose petal, volatile oil extraction from rose petal, enabling us to get a highly rich fragmenting extracts from the rose and other flowers. Otherwise, in general, we utilize the method called as enflurage for the extraction, enflurage for the extraction of volatile components or from the for flowers using paraffin wax bed, etc. But this method of supercritical fluid enhances the ability to extract the volatile components. Certain advantages of SFE. So, it is higher diffusion rates than the other liquids as already discussed, lower viscosities than the liquid solvents as already discussed. Then we have this higher vapor pressure than the liquid solvents, higher density compared to the gases and hence higher solvating power. Then we have solubility and to some extent selectivity can also be controlled or modified using the various parameters of supercritical fluid extraction. We have low polarity of carbon dioxide that can be modified with certain co-solvents and enhance the extraction. Again, there are suitable heat sensitive compounds which could be easily and efficiently, I must say, be extracted using this super critical fluid method. Then we have certain disadvantages also with super critical fluid. The common one is that most it is having carbon dioxide, which is the most common solvent utilized, is having low polarity and hence cannot extract polar compounds. Then in presence of water, there could be problems and unpredictability of the matrix effect. Next is need of specialized or expensive equipment. It cannot be done in any lab like simple lab or academic institute. There has to be specialized costly equipment as well as expertise to handle this particular extraction. Next is the various types of extracts. So, under this category, we will describe what are the various types, its utility, maybe some examples with this. The first one under this category is the aqueous extract. So, these extracts have a very high medicinal, are intended for medicinal preparations and they have to be immediately utilized after the preparation or to be preserved for use, because since it is having water and ability to easily get contaminated, so either it preservative has to be added or has to be immediately consumed. Then we have this decoction. This is a very ancient method of decoction, is a very ancient type of extract, which is more popular process of extracting water soluble and heat stable constituents from a crude drug by boiling in the water for about 10 to 15 minutes. So, this is the method what we follow for in our day to day life for preparing the tea, where the tea is boiled with the water for a given time and the since the material is heat stable, it is extracted. Okay, next is the boiled crude drugs or water mixture is then here cooled, filtered. Sufficient volume of the cold water is passed through the drug and then required volume is produced in decoction. Okay. Next is infusion. Okay. Now, this infusion is generally a dilute solution of readily soluble constituents of the crude drugs and it is nothing but a type of periodic maceration of the drug with either cold or boiling water. So, again here we are not just boiling the drug simultaneously, but what we are doing is we are adding boiling water or cold water and the periodically macerating the drug. So, the soluble water soluble constituents gets readily into the solvent system. Okay. So, infusion is also filtered to remove from the crude vegetable material and then produced in a required volume by addition of water. Next is digestion. The fourth one here is digestion. It is also a type of maceration in which moderate heating is preferred. So, till now we were exposed to the concept that maceration is a generally a preferred closed and cold process, but here moderate heating is preferred during the extraction. This heating causes digestion of the drug material and increases the solvent efficiency. Mind it, here it is not boiled, just minor digestion is done to increase the solvent efficiency. Then it is preferred for the drugs which use moderately elevated temperature and does not cause degradation of the constituents. So, again here comes the factor, the nature of the phytoconstituent or the plant material. So, if it does not degrade, then we can elevate the temperature to increase the solubility. So, this I have already mentioned types like tinctures. So, tinctures are defined as the alcoholic or hydroalcoholic, that means water plus alcoholic solution prepared from the crude drugs or from pure or organic or inorganic substances. Either it is a prepared from crude drug or from pure organic and inorganic substances. When we talk about the, you know, the unorganized drugs, obviously it is the crude drug, okay, the gums and raisins, but there are certain organic substances, certain aldehydes, acids, formulated and dispensed in forms of tinctures. Okay, so it may contain some 10 to 20 grams of drug per 100 ml of the tincture. This method is used for the preparation of tincture number 1, maceration, number 2, percolation. Then iodine tincture, this is again the inorganic tincture, is an it is used for as a disinfectant. Then we have this belladonna, which is obtained from a alkaloidal preparation obtained from leaves this is obtained by percolation method, while the benzoin tincture is an resin and it is obtained from the unorganized drug material. Then we have this sweet orange peel tincture prepared by the maceration. Okay, moving to our next slide, the dry extract. Okay, now moving to the next slide, that is liquid extract. So, liquid extract is termed as fluid extracts in some official books like USP, and it is a liquid preparation of crude drugs which contain ethyl alcohol as a solvent as well as a preservative. It may contain active constituents to the extent of 1 gram of drug per ml. So, liquid extract contains 1 gram of the drug per ml. And the pharmacopoeia liquid extracts are prepared by either percolation or by modified percolation technique. Next is the soft extract, which is produced as semi-solid or liquids of syrupy consistency and are termed as soft extracts. These are used in variety of dosage forms ranging from ointment, suppositories, and can be used in the preparation of some other pharmaceuticals as well. Example, glycyrrhiza extract USP, which is in the form of soft extract. Next is the dry extract. So, it is also known as the powdered extract or dry powders, and the total extract obtained by using suitable process of extraction are filtered, concentrated preferably by vacuum and then dry it completely. So, tray drying or spray drying techniques are used for making these dry extracts. Just like soft extracts, these powder extracts can be used for manufacturing of some medicinal preparation. Generally, we use them for various formulation development works. So, powdered extracts are used in solid dry dosage forms like capsules, powders or tablets. The belladonna extract or the hyoscyamus extract are the official dry extract. With this, we wind up our topic of extraction of crude drugs, and the books referred for this purpose is S.L. Dore, The Pharmacognosy and Phytochemistry Comprehensive Approach, second edition 2018 by PharmaMed Press. We have also referred Biren and Shah, Textbook of Pharmacognosy and Phytochemistry by CBS Publication. We have also referred Dr. C.K. Kokate, Textbook of Pharmacognosy by Nirali Publication. And thank you for your patient listening.